Hi guys, I'm Fabio De Fio and welcome to my YouTube channel. As you know, this month is Inspire Your Life. But I changed the topic of this week because we are all back on lockdown and it's going to be a bit challenging, difficult. So I will not talk about a positive emotion. I will talk about an unpleasant emotion called loneliness. This is my topic of this week. How to deal with loneliness and how to deal with the loneliness during a lockdown. Let's talk about loneliness. Loneliness is an unpleasant emotion, but reading some research, and especially one of my favorite research was from John Cacioppo, who said that loneliness is a state of mind. And I really believe in that. First of all, I can call myself as an expert of loneliness. Why? Let me tell you about. I'm 37 years old, and for my first 30 years of my life, I felt lonely most of the time because, as you know, I told you many times my stories, my background, the people around me. So I never heard deep relationship, but I never heard people who were really close to me in a way that I could exchange, I couldn't be really myself. So I felt really lonely. When you feel lonely, there is a big sense of emptiness, there is a feel of the self-esteem is really low, and there are so many issues around this topic. So being an expert on loneliness, I can talk about really well about that. Loneliness is something that people don't understand sometimes very well, because you can stay in your house like right now and feel lonely, but you can stay as well in a room with 1,000 people, with some friends, and you will feel lonely as well. So what is the difference? Because there is something inside of us that doesn't work, because we feel that these people, we don't trust these people. There's something that doesn't feel right. I call the member of lonely people around the world, the heart club of lonely people around the world, has a lot of memberships and has millions and millions of people. I live in a country that I love so much. I love England. But at the same time, 2 years ago, they made the decision to have a minister of loneliness, because here is such a big deal that they tried and they are trying right now to find the solutions. Because loneliness is not anymore a problem of older people, but it's a problem of all people with all kind of ages, and especially the younger generation. We love right now all social networks, but sometimes they can be in a really in a state of mind that is not anymore the connection with other people, but with the phone, with the laptop. They don't try to have any more conversation with the other human being. That we are being human beings, we need a connection. I know that after we'll talk in my next talk about the loneliness during the pandemic, so how you can be active, all these kind of things, but loneliness in general as a topic, we need connection. Secondly, that is really, really important about loneliness. Being loneliness is a choice, and being lonely is a choice, and with all the choice, you can change that. How? There are different kind of ways to change that. I remember one of my clients came to me, and one of his biggest issues was to feel lonely. And we were talking, and I asked a few questions, And he said, Fabio, we'll never get through about this feeling. One of really important facts about loneliness that we think that we are the only people in the world, and this is not true. At the second time, it's really important to find what is behind this person, what are the hobbies, if there are hobbies, there are passion as well, if you're lonely, but you can have other, some passion. Passion is really important. And my client, when we were talking, said, Fabio, I love being with nature, I love hiking sometimes on my own, or everything on my own. So we start talking about this big passion. I understood that the more we were talking about that, the more he was happy. So we have been working on, we have worked on that until he started looking for a group of people that were doing hiking, and so we found this group of people with 6 people. They start doing together. So he, with a small step, that for me I'm a big fan of a small step, he changed his perception of being lonely. For me, in my case, was when I moved here five years ago, or when I moved, when I had when I changed completely my life, there I felt, okay, I'm not anymore lonely, but I am in a state of mind that I can be on my own, because I like to be alone, because it's a moment where I can be creative as well, when I do my talks, or when I do my, after a session with a client, I can think about. But at the same time, I have a few friends, but they're really important. I trust them, and everything become more easier in a certain way, because at the same time, when I have some issues, I know that these people, they're going to be for me. Right now, loneliness is such a big deal. People are afraid to talk about that. I remember yesterday I had a call with a friend. Let's say I'm going to have this week completely different than the week I programmed for my YouTube channel. And he said, no, please don't talk about loneliness. Don't. It was like, no, please don't do it. Say, no, I'm going to do it, because I will talk about a subject that I'm going to be uncomfortable. But it's going to be as well people that can listen, and my main message is that you are not alone, because the worst thing you can think is in your mind that you are the only one, and I'm telling you, there are millions and millions and millions of people around the world, and remember, being lonely is a choice, and with all the choice, you can change it. Hope that you enjoyed my first part of loneliness, and I will wait for loneliness during the pandemic. Remember, be true to you, and I will wait for my next talk. Bye.